guys, Dynamite Jack back again with another video, and this time I bought a TV. I've been looking at televisions for a while, and I decided to go with the Sony Bravia HX800. It's the one that jumped out the most to me at the store, so I brought it home with me. This is a 55-inch 3D LED television with 240Hz motion flow and internet video and all that good stuff, and I'm going to be replacing my Samsung 46-inch. I bought the entertainment bundle, so besides the TV, it also comes with two pairs of Sony 3D active glasses, the 3D sync transmitter, and the Wi-Fi adapter. If you look at the top of the box, you get a quick rundown of the features the TV has. It has dynamic edge-lit LED, 240Hz motion flow, deep black panel, Sony Bravia 3 engine, Bravia internet video, Curiosity, I have no idea what that is. It's wireless LAN ready. Full 1080p, of course. Four HDMI inputs. Energy Star approved. All that good stuff. You get two free movies and four free games. When you register with Sony, they mail the movies to you. You get Bolt 3D and Michael Jackson's This Is It 3D. The games are downloadable, so you get them right away. It's MotorStorm Pacific Rift. I believe it's just a demo. Wipeout HD, Pain, and Super Stardust HD. Okay, I'm going to assemble it and hook everything up, and I'll be back in a second. All right, I got everything set up, and here's a better look at the Sony HX800. It has a black finish with a glossy screen, and the frame that goes around the top and the bottom is only about an inch thick, so it isn't too bulky. Here's a closer look at the frame. It's not overly reflective, which was important to me, and one of the reasons I went with Sony. I'm not a fan of Samsung's chrome look that they have going on this year. Here's a side view. The TV is about 1 inch thick up at the top, and towards the bottom it gets a little bit bigger. It says it's 2.8 inches, which is still pretty thin if you ask me. Much thinner than what I had. Here's a look at the back. You have two HDMI inputs, a VGA PC input, an Ethernet input for your LAN, along with two component inputs and a stereo and optical audio outs. And then you have your cable antenna and your little 3D sync transmitter, funky little input. Over on the left side, you have a USB 2.0 input, two more HDMI inputs, and a composite input if you're like me and still have an old VCR lying around. On the right side, you have your basic controls like power, channel, volume, etc. And down here, you have an energy saving switch that turns off all the power to the TV and conserves energy. See how it's written in green? You can't miss it. Here's the remote that comes with the TV. It's your standard remote that Sony's packing with a lot of things these days. It has an internet video button and a 3D button, home button in the center. One thing I like is there's a power switch located on the back where your finger rests, so it's easy to turn the TV on and off. It's a great little idea. Here's a close look at the 3D glasses. They look stylish and not as cumbersome as some other brands, and they have shielding on the sides to block out the light. On each side of the frames, you have a switch that you can adjust the width of the glasses to make them more comfortable, right here. And next to that is the battery, which is like the kind you use in watches. Supposedly they last up to about 100 hours. We'll see. Here's a look through the lens of the glasses. You can see that it tints things just slightly, but the TV compensates for making the 3D image brighter, so you don't have to worry about it looking dull or washed out. This is the 3D transmitter. The way this works is you plug it in the back of your TV and put it either below or above it, and it transmits 3D. It has a strange proprietary jack that's kind of shaped like a heart. You can see. Finally, we got the Wi-Fi adapter, which basically looks like a USB memory stick that you stick in the side of your TV, and you get the internet. Comes with an extension cable, which I thought was interesting. So maybe you can move it around and find a sweet spot if you have trouble getting the internet to your TV. Okay, guys, I'll be back later with another more in-depth video reviewing the television. But if you have any questions about the TV, feel free to leave them in the comment section, and I'll try to answer them as best I can. As always, I'd like to thank you very much for watching. Until next time, have a nice day.